Welcome to the Thrasher's Wheat Radio Hour, where the feedback is back.
I come down from the misty mountain.
Every week we scour the human highway to bring you the best Neil Young news and reviews, rumors and musings, plus rare unreleased tracks and live shows that will keep you rocking in the free world.
It's all one song!
The Thrasher's Wheat Radio Hour is presented by WBKM.org in the heart of Burlington, Vermont.
I didn't hear you come in. I was just reminiscing on that great old tune of Willie's, and I'm feeling something special. And here comes Thrasher. Good morning, Thrasher.
Good morning, Tony. It sounded like a familiar voice and a familiar song. Something about being on the road again. Do you feel that you might be on the road again?
I feel it's happening. I just feel it. I feel the pressure in the tires of the minivan going up. I feel the summer heat sort of still out there in a crisp, very early fall day. And yeah, I am. I think you are too.
That's right. You know, I tell you what, Tony,
tell me what.
How about we hit the road? And where should we go? And when should we go?
Well, maybe we shouldn't go too far because you never know when they tell you to get the hell back home. So maybe we'll keep it up here in the Northeast, somewhere equidistant between you and I. I don't know, Massachusetts, Connecticut, something like that. What are you thinking? Not too far.
Well, you know, I think it'd be great to go to Farm Aid 2021.
Wait, we're talking virtual, right? We're not talking real live farmers.
No, I think we should go to a concert.
We're doing it, folks. That's it. That's right. As you know by now, if you're a fan of the event, if you're a fan of any of these incredible artists, Farm Aid 2021 is the real deal. It's not going to be virtual, like unfortunately had to happen in 2020. It will be 2019 all over again. Maybe the beers have gone a little longer overnight. We'll have to see.
Yeah, Tony. You know, tell us what you know here. I'll pull up a little bit of stuff here about what's going on here. I think
we can
probably see some of the Farm Aid imagery there, maybe.
Yeah, I like that image. You know, I always like them. I'm always amazed at what people come up with to lay down this imagery that always involves some musical theme along with the farming. I think this is a really outstanding one. You know, that guitar laying down there, it looks like it's a fence, it's sunrise. And there you see a great, great mural of a bunch of folks out there celebrating. That was from 2019, was it now? Wisconsin.
Yeah, 2019, Wisconsin, right. But yeah, before we, I guess roll back, let's talk about what we know about 2021.
Yeah, man. Well, of course, we have what we call the big four, the executive board members of Willie, Neil, John Mellencamp, Dave Matthews, and
Margo Price is now. Margo Price is now on the board.
Margo's back. I love hearing Margo. She's had a baby last time. She was on that stage looking lovely and expectant, and she has had her baby. And so we're going to see some some old friends. We're going to see Jamie Johnson again, who I really love to see. And I had a chance to talk to Jamie in 2019. First time. A real gentle bear. The guy looks like he's somebody you should be afraid of meeting in the dark, but gentle, gentle soul. Looking forward to those things. Nathaniel Rateliff and the Night Sweats, a big highlight in the last couple of times they've been there. Great band, right? How about you? Who are you looking forward to seeing in the earlier part of the middle of the day, perhaps?
Well, Tony, you know, I have to say, you know, really love them all. You know, like you said, Nathaniel Rateliff, Thurgil Simpson, Tyler Childers. But I would probably have to say, much like in 2019, you know, kind of a highlight of the day was, you know, the return of Tanya Tucker and, you know, all that history and really got the crowd fired up. And, and I would probably have to bet that this year, Betty LaVette will be sort of the, I'm not sure exactly how to categorize a special guest like Betty LaVette, but she could be that perform that sort of that role.
Yeah, I think you're right. And who was it? You know, a good number of years ago now, I guess more than I remember. Who, you know, we've had a couple of those sort of special. I don't know really what the word is, right? Not archive kind of guests, but you know, the iconic, I guess, guests that come out and really, really showed up. You know, like Tanya. You know, she wasn't from yesterday. I mean, she really showed up. And she put it out there. She put out there what she had. Bonnie Raitt has done that in the past, certainly more than once. And there's always magic. Farm Aid is always magic. If you folks have tickets, there's Bonnie looking beautiful as always. That great slide on her guitar. Wonderful little smile. Go back to that little smile of Dave and Neil, would you, a minute? Because Dave doesn't smile a lot. And when he does, you really want to capture it. And that's a heck of a chuckle out of Neil there. I don't know who said what. Dave's holding the mic.
Yeah.
He said something really got him, right?
Yeah. Looks like Neil's got his tongue out a little bit there, too.
Yeah, he's just, I mean, really, you know. And that a little bit refers also to the press conference that we're very fortunate to be able to attend year after year as media kind of peoples. And always good, always informative, always intelligent. There's the lovely Margot Price there. Very lovely.
Yeah, a lot of great faces that we'll see again. And there's Tanya Tucker.
I got a point right today. See that spot right there? Yeah. I got a little kiss from Margot in 2018.
Ooh.
She was hanging out with Lucas and she acted like she knew me. And I took it. I was like, right there. Oh, yeah.
Right there.
Haven't watched it yet. But I might have to this time. I'm hoping for a refresh. Margo, if you're out there, let's do this side this time. But it's always great. It's always great. You know, you and I, unfortunately, don't get to see each other, but once a year. And there's going to be that we look forward to. And who knows what special fun guests from out there in the world of travelers and music lovers that we will get to meet. Always a surprise, always a really good surprise.
Yeah, definitely, Tony. And of course, you know, one of the best parts of these kind of, you know, large festival day-long events like Farm Aid, you know, like, you know, Neil Young's Bridge School, are when you get those artist hookups where, you know, Neil Young will walk out and play with one of the guests. You know, those are usually the really special moments, and you get that at Farm Aid a lot. You know, not really Neil walking out and being a special guest, but usually, you know, folks like Lucas Nelson show up in a lot of different people's sets. Margot Price has it.
Lucas can't help playing with everybody and it works. It's never like, oh, geez, there's Lucas again. You know, chill out, Lucas. No, it's always good, and folks come out because they want to play with him. They certainly want to play with Promise of the Real. Who was it that sang last year with Lucas, who just blew us away?
Well, I know Margot Price comes out there, and I believe that the performer known as Yola, I believe.
Yola is the one who was trading those high notes with Lucas, and they were just trying to outbust each other's lungs. Boy, was that special, huh?
Definitely.
Mm. A lot of good memories. We're talking over each other sometimes. That was my first introduction to Yola. I had heard the name. But I certainly went away a fan and made sure that the station here at WBKM was loaded up with her music. Because, wow, that's a talent. So that's what Farm Aid's about, folks. Boy, oh boy. Hope you can make it.
Yeah, definitely. You know, those artist hookups we mentioned, as well as, you know, checking out new artists that, you know, we're not familiar with at all. Maybe, you know, I think Allison Russell is a name I saw on the bill for this thing. I'm not familiar with her whatsoever.
No, that's early on in the day, I think, right? We've got to see Ian Mellencamp as well, starting it up. Ian will start it up after Willie comes out and sings the Lord's Prayer with our Native American friends, which is, again, something, you know, really, if I want to chide the audience about anything, it's, you know, please don't stay in the parking lot until 7 p.m. You're going to miss a lot of great music and a lot of great moments. Sure, let's be honest, you know, we do put a lot of attention on the Big Four, and but you know, the Big Four became the Big Four because at one point, maybe a whole lot of years ago, they weren't the Big Four. They earned it. And so let's give these younger people and these other groups that start the show and come out during the hot afternoon, let's give them their due, and you treat yourself. You're gonna be blessed by it, folks.
Yeah, definitely, Tony. And I think, you know, here we are, we're in July. We got like maybe 2 months or so out from the show. I know we'll be talking about this a lot more as we come up to it, because I don't think we can really in any way, I'll say, either overhype this or underplay this event, the magnitude of it. This would probably be for 2021. I mean, it's a little early to project this out, but in terms of a major musical event in this country and in this world, nothing else is out there on the radar of this magnitude in terms of this many people, this many artists. Now, in a typical year, you know, yeah, this is just another kind of big concert thing, but we know that this isn't just a typical year. This is really kind of I want to say a bit of a breakthrough coming up here, and let's just all sort of lock arms and make sure that this doggone thing goes off as planned.
Yeah. And take it in. You know, one of the things that I personally always do at a big show, and I did it in 2019, you know, I love turning around and just taking a snapshot mentally of all the people, incredibly different people, all the races, all the beliefs, all the persuasions, both sides of the political aisle and in the middle and everything all over. I just find it's just beautiful, because there is this great thing that happens when people share music and when they share good food. And Farm Aid is about both things. And so look around at your neighbors, you know, make new friends. You may never see them again, but for 15 minutes while Neil is going, or Dave or John or Willie, they might become the best friend you ever had.
Yeah, you're right there, Tony. And like we were just saying, I think we'll talk a lot more about all this in the run up to it in September. But you know, you mentioned about the crowd and the diversity. That just brought to me one of the mental images that I've had at Farm Aid, where you can literally see a true old school farmer, cowboy hat, overalls, boots, standing next to, you know, a punker with spiky hair and chopped off t-shirt, and they're grooving out to Willie Nelson or whoever.
Yep. It makes us a lot closer and reminds us to drop that thing that maybe other forces have suggested, which is that, oh, we're too different to get along. No, we're not too different to get along. Farm Aid is one of those beautiful places that shows us what happens when you just let people get along? You know, it's like bringing a new cat into the house, and the old cat's kind of like, yeah, I don't know. But you know what? You leave them, and they get along. And so FarmAid has created a wonderfully peaceful event. And, well, we're not at all excited, so we probably won't even refer to this again. Whatever.
Well, Tony, I think, you know, this is all, you know, like I say, good run-up to September, and we'll talk a lot more about it. But what do you think? Is it time to have a little FarmAid memory here?
I would love to have a little FarmAid memory. What are we got some ideas out there. What are you going to throw at us right now, Thrasher?
Well, you know, Tony, I think, you know, we were talking about what would be good to show here for this, and what might, you know, sort of encapsulate the FarmAid spirit of things. And, you know, you brought up, you know, of course, we obviously we love Neil Young, we love Promise the Real, we love Lucas, we love Micah, we love good song. So, you know, it's you know, there's a lot to choose from. So, you know, poor us, lucky us. So I think, you know, you had suggested Throw Your Hatred Down, and got that up on the screen. You can see it, right?
Yeah, originally on the Mirrorball album. With members of Pearl Jam and Neil and the Real, as we sort of shortened it down. Boy, did they whip that thing, and it was a frenzy. And, you know, there was a little bit of an acoustic set, and then Neil turns around and he picks up Old Black, and you just feel this 20 million volts of electricity just come out of the ground. And then Neil turns it up.
Yeah, definitely. Good sort of lead into this. So I think what we'll try and do here, Tony, you know, this, if you're looking at the screen here, you can see that this is a fundraiser donation, you know, trying to raise money for FarmAid. That is what this is all about. I know we do focus on the music and the artists and those things, but it is about the farmers, and it is about the cause. And you know, I know we could spend a lot of time, you know, talking about the philosophies of the family farm and good food movement and non-GMOs and all of those I'll say sub threads to the subject. But let's get to the music and let's see if we can just play this whole song. I think it runs about, you know, 6 minutes or so. We don't usually run a whole song, but let's go ahead and run a whole song here. And as we said, you know, it's part of the fundraiser here for FarmAid. So if you're listening out there, you know, go out there to FarmAid and you know, make that donation, because, you know, it's not just, you know, one day a year. It's all year.
No, it is a major event. It is their major fundraising event of the year, but the work goes on all year. Those incredible people from Carolyn Mugar, the executive director, and that staff of folks down in Boston, and the four executive board members who have dedicated since 1985 to three, and then Dave later years, they've dedicated a lot of time and energy to supporting family farms and the food that you put in your children's body. So FarmAid.org, you can send a donation all the time. You can send it while you're listening to this, folks. Please do.
Definitely. Yep. All right. So let's go ahead and do this. This is from FarmAid 2019, which was Milwaukee, Wisconsin. And again, Neil Young, Promise the Real, Throw Your Hatred Down. Here we go.
Love it. So big screen. Yeah, baby.
Thank you.
Wow. You know, Thrasher, we were there. I was there. We saw you in the front row, right towards the end there. I hope folks got to see that. But it's almost like I never saw that before. I literally was just carried away in the last 6 minutes, you know, watching Corey and Micah bouncing. Micah with that gorgeous hair that he's still got, God bless him, and Lucas looking almost reverent of the words. Anthony, one of Anthony LaGurfo, perhaps the best young drummer in America. Tato on the percussion. What do you say, man, huh?
Yeah, Tony, you know, just watching that kind of stuff, one of the things, many things, cross your mind. One is how great it is that these things are captured in high def video, multicam, soundboard video. I mean, so that, future generations someday will be able to say, oh yeah, 2019, Farm Aid. Yeah. That's great. As you mentioned, when they do those wide shots out to the crowd, I know we were down there in front. I could sort of remember where we were standing there, there was sort of just knowing we were right there in the zone and digging every moment of Old Black shredding, and just kind of like always, the camera guys are trying to follow close ups of Old Black, and it's great, because as soon as they get it framed up, off it goes.
I remember one of my dear moments, remembering that I was standing next to two people whose names I don't even think I found out at the time. And we were dancing and we were screaming and we were crying and we were collapsing in a hug at the end of it, because the energy level in that room, okay, and now it's already high, but when Neil turned around with Old Black and that thing started, I couldn't believe, first of all, I've never seen Neil do that live in a band or with anything. And the power of that thing, like I said, 2 million volts, whatever I said, it wasn't enough. It wasn't enough. The electricity in that room, I mean.
Yeah, it's good memory, good call there. So I'd say, before we move off and wrap up here, Tony, a lot of speculation about who Neil Young will be playing with. I mean, he's recording an album with Crazy Horse now. There was a full moon last night, and so the word is Crazy Horse, but the announcement is, it doesn't specifically say Neil Young and Crazy Horse as an artist performing. It does say Promise of the Real, obviously. I would say the betting line at the moment is that Neil Young will be playing with Promise of the Real, Lucas and Micah Nelson and the band there that you mentioned. And you can see that is kind of what we can probably expect, just some good rockin' music from Neil and the Real.
Absolutely. I think it's a rather unique thing that one of your favorite artists, plays with this group or plays with this group, and you really can say, I'm going to fall in love with whichever group he shows up with. I don't think that can be said for a lot of bands, but they're both very different, whether it's Crazy Horse or Promise of the Real. They're, of course, incredibly different. Crazy Horse has a legacy that, of course, the young men in Promise of the Real don't have yet. But I'm not going to be at all disappointed in whoever Neil shows up with to play with, because there's then 73-year-old Neil Young playing with the folks who have just barely reached 30, and not even that for all of them. It's Uncle Neil. This is somebody that they've grown up with for a long time, certainly Lucas and Micah. And what a gift. Whatever you come with, Neil, it's going to be spectacular. Thank you.
Absolutely. And like I said, before we maybe move off of that, this will be Neil Young's first live concert performance since Farm Aid 2019. So this will be full 2 years without a live concert performance. So I would have to say during Neil Young's career, there has never been a stretch this long where he has never performed a concert. So, you know, what's he going to be bringing? Obviously, he's in the studio. So he's still, you know, got his chops and all of that. But as we all know, you know, getting in front of an audience and playing and working out all that sort of technicalities and working with the band, you know, are we going to see, you know, Neil Young walk on stage and strap on and just kind of come out of the gates as the first time? Or are we going to have some sort of warm-up performance? Now, historically, like in 2019, which I believe Neil had been off the road, you know, he ended up like hooking up with Promise of the Real, who had been out on tour, to do a warm-up, pre-Farm Aid warm-up show in Indiana, if you remember that. So we got to be on the lookout for that, Tony. We got to look for that warm-up show coming up the week before Farm Aid. So everybody, get ready, because, you know, that's a real opportunity. If you can't make it to Farm Aid, you know, it's already sold out. Isn't that right, Tony?
It literally sold out in 10 minutes. And I'm talking about lawn seats too. People are hungry for real. They're hungry to see a show of this magnitude and hungry to support and be together. That's astonishing. And hats off to the good folks down in Boston for making that happen.
Yeah, absolutely. So folks who did not get Farm Aid tickets, who wanted to get that, as Tony said, you know, this is a hot, high demand ticket, and people want to be there. And I mean, be there for a lot of different reasons, just to get out of the house kind of stuff and rock it out with friends. And really, I think we would all agree, you know, that's what life's all about. So let's get back to life. But like we said, there could be a warm-up show. So be alert, be ready, get your bags packed to hit the road, wherever that's going to be. The concert's in Hartford. So I guess our best bet would be there's an Outlaw tour that's going along with Willie and Micah and Lucas and the Real. So that would be the spot to see Neil Young come for a warm-up show. Look for those run-up dates in that week before. Stake it out and make it happen.
All right. Well, this is why we all go to thrashersweek.org as often as we can, because if anybody's going to know about it, going to be Thrasher. So keep reading.
Well, yeah, we got a lot of folks out there who are combing the internet, and you know, they're on all the social medias and everything, and feeding us tips and so on. So we appreciate that. You know, it's not really anything, you know, extraordinarily like an inside track that we've got on everything. It's just we got a lot of listeners, as Tony mentioned. So why don't we just close out here with a little last video here, Tony?
Yeah, I love it. What do you got in mind?
Well, you know, as we were kind of figuring out what we wanted to play here, this, you know, the Throw Your Hatred Down, you know, doing the full thing. It's, you know, if you've been to Farm Aid, you know, at the end of the night, end of the day, you know, after 12 hours of music, Willie comes out, you know, he's looking kind of fresh and ready to go. Everybody else is pretty wiped out. He's been hanging out on the bus all day. You know, everybody who's been playing there at the concert will come out on stage and do a sort of a group medley of different stuff. Hopefully you can see the screen up there, Tony.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So as I was mentioning, you know, this is just really a fun time of the night. You know, it's the end of the day. Everybody's, you know, wiped out, but still, you know, hungry for more music. And of course, when you just see all the artists come out and you just see the smiles in their face, you know, it's just such a wonderful way to end the day, end the night, and then, you know, start heading out to the parking lot to get out of the venue. So we've got this from 2019, again, from Milwaukee, the I'll Fly Away medley there sort of at the end, Willie Nelson. But you can see who's on stage there. And if you're looking kind of close, you see, you see Neil there, you know, you probably see he's got a big smile on his face, and Lucas is looking over there, and there's Willie, and I think that's Mike over there. And so what I was thinking, we're not going to play the whole 10-minute thing here, but I think we'll just see if we can dip in and out and catch some close-ups and some smiles, some different folks. In particular, I'll be looking for Margo with her baby out there and see if we can catch that, and we'll squeeze this 10 minutes into, you know, just a few minutes and close it out.
That's great. I love it.
All right, here we go.
Will the circle be unbroken? About to say,
will the circle be unbroken? By and by, oh, by and by,
baby.
Only heading in the sky, Lord, in the sky.
Play it, little sister. Undertaker, 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 won't you please run slow? There's a body that you care. On the way in the sky, Lord, in the sky. So I'm glad more than when this life is over.
I'll fly away
to a land on God's celestial shore.
I'll fly away,
everybody say.
That was great. Look at those amazing people on that stage.
Yeah, brings back some memories there, doesn't it, Tony?
Many of them, because, you know, that's the way it goes out. So, it's like 1985 or it's 2019. I'm not sure which one in between. But what a great thing. What a great family. Seeing the sister on that piano, boy, playing that thing. How many times has Willie played that song? My goodness. What a treasure.
Yeah. Yeah. A lot of history on that stage there, Tony, a lot of history on that stage. And, you know, I think as we wrap up here, you know, this is really, you know, got me excited for 2021 in a big way. I was excited, looking forward to this announcement. I know we've talked about it, I think, you know, for ever since we did our first 2.0 broadcast, started hyping this thing up, right?
Oh, yeah. Well, I've got some friends in St. Louis that I've been getting together with them for 12 out of the last 13 farm aids. And I mean, we start talking about it in January. Hey, when's it coming? When's the announcement? I can't wait. I can't see you. And that's a lot about what it is, right? It's that fraternity of folks that you just, you know, you don't see them. But that day, and what a day. We'll be there.
Yep, a great day of music. All right. Well, Tony, we'll wrap it up here, and you'll have to remind me again, like, so why are we doing this, Tony?
Because I feel like I owe it, and you owe it to someone.
Keep on rocking, Tony.
Thank you, my friend Thrasher. Thank you, everybody, for checking this one out. Pretty much an extended version, and I'm going to watch it again. Take care, everybody. See you next time.